31-31 series continues. Today we're talking about the New Jersey Devils. Dan Rosen here, EJ Hradek.
The Devils!
If they gave out a trophy for the off-season champions, the Devils would get the trophy.
Yeah, they,
there's
they've
no
had a,
question
they've had
about
a really
it.
Good off-season.
This is a good off-season.
You know, they don't give out that trophy.
They
though,
don't.
Dan.
They don't. But I, yeah. maybe we should make one.
Nah.
Nah. Nah. We'll just talk about it. Then.
Yeah, we'll talk about
Jack
it.
Jack Hughes, the number one pick. He's a Devil. P.K. Subban acquired in a trade. He's a Devil. Wayne Simmonds signed to a one-year deal. Nikita Gusev, maybe the best player who was not in the National Hockey League.
I really like Nikita
outside
Gusev.
Of Jack Hughes, who was not in the National Hockey
League. That's true,
So they got probably the two best guys who were not in the National Hockey League last season, perhaps. Now they've got them as well. So what an offseason for the Devils. A remake after a team struggled last year. Missed the playoffs by 26 points after making it the year before. Big problem.
And they had a good start last year. Remember they won their first four
or
five
games? Yeah, they won their
first
four games. And Jackie Redmond was on my case because I didn't have them in the number one in the Super 16.
That's right. There
she
you go.
She was on my – you were on my case too.
Yeah, well, at the time, we were right. As it turned out, it wasn't correct.
Anyway,
all right.
Big problem was Taylor Hall obviously didn't play after December 23rd last year. He had 37 points in 30 games. The other problem was goaltending.
Yeah, all big issue.
Big issue. But the Devils as a whole, with all these changes, you know, I mean, what do you make of the New
Jersey
Devils?
Well, listen,
now?
I like
hey, the watch them now.
I like, first of all, they're going to be a lot more interesting to follow this year. There's no question about that. I like the future of this franchise. When you think of moving forward with Jack Hughes and with Nico Hischier as your 1-2 down the middle, I mean, two first overall picks in the last 3 years, that is a big-time deal for a franchise. And I think both those guys, Hischier has been a really good player so far. I think Jack Hughes is going to he's going to be a great player for a long time in this league. They add P.K. Subban on defense, and P.K. Subban brings them a whole lot. He's
off
a good
and off the ice.
Listen, he's a good defenseman. Maybe sometimes a little overrated, and I think PK, it's going to be on him. He's got 3 years left on his contract. He's getting paid pretty handsomely at the $9 million per year. I love the term for the Devils. They get him for 3 years. They're not locked in for 6 or 8 years.
Right.
See how things play out, and at the end of that 3 years, if PK likes being with the Devils and the Devils have been very satisfied with his production, he stays on another contract, and if not, they're not tied in long for long term. So I love that. But if PK Subban puts in the work, which he's going to have to do aside from the work he does, whether charitable work, which is wonderful, work in building his own brand, which is fun to watch.
Yeah, no problem with that.
Puts in the work that he has done in the past and is a very productive, helpful, puck-moving right-shot defenseman for the Devils, and that's a huge acquisition for a number of reasons for that franchise. And, you know, the one you mentioned, Nikita Gusev, they just acquired him from the Vegas Golden Knights, and I really like Nikita Gusev. I've seen him play at the Olympics. I know that was a B tournament in 2018.
Sure. He was the best forward there.
But he was, for me, he was by far. And the Russian team, remember, they had Ilya Kovalchuk on the team. People were talking about how, Kovalchuk, and, you know, he was a big player. He was at the back end of the lineup by the end of that tournament. Gusev was the guy that won them the gold medal with his play in the third period in overtime against Germany. So we will see. It's always hard to predict exactly how a guy is going to fit into the National Hockey League. It's different than playing in a B tournament in the Olympics or playing in the KHL, which, by the way, he was very productive.
More than a point. 82 points in 62
more than
KHL
a point,
games.
More than a point a game for the last couple of years in the KHL. I really like Gusev. I think he's going to be a player for the Devils. Even if it doesn't work out, they trade for him a second and a third round pick over the couple of years, 4.5. Over 2 years, if he's, let's say he's a big bust in year one, you can buy him out of that second year and move on.
They have the cap space. This is it's cap management. It was brilliant cap management, I think, from Ray Shiro.
They have the room.
They have the room.
I'm going to be really excited to see Gusev, though. I think he is outside of the the Jack Hughes and Kapo Kakko with the New York Rangers. Those two young players. Outside of those two, I'm most interested to see what happens with Gusev this year because I just think he's really good. I want to see if I'm going to be right about
it. You know the two players on the New Jersey Devils who I'm most interested in seeing?
Who?
Taylor Hall
and
Corey Schneider.
That's right. We haven't even talked about them yet. And they were like they were the linchpin of this team, when you think about them from a couple of years back.
Yeah. Taylor Hall, Hart Trophy. Last year, they struggled. He didn't play. That's a big issue, that not have your best player. He is still, we could talk about Hughes and Subban and Goose. He's still their best player.
Yeah.
And let's get to it, because if they're going to do any damage this season, if they're going to make the playoffs this season, Corey Schneider has to start playing like a $6 million goaltender.
Yeah, well, he's had injuries and is definitely a setback in his career. Now, late in the season last year. He went through that long stretch where he didn't get a win, right? It was in a regular season game. He hadn't had a win for more than a year.
Yeah.
But he started to play better towards the end of the season. He played the World Championships. He played okay. Mackenzie Blackwood is someone to keep an eye on. He played well in spurts for the Devils last year. He was a young goaltender, a Devil draft pick. Maybe that combination can get it together. But that's my biggest fear about the Devils is the goaltending. Is it going to be good enough on a night-to-night basis to help this team? How are these young players going to – are we asking too much of Jack Hughes and some of the other younger players to really have a big piece of this? But you mentioned Taylor Hall going into the final year of his contract. Will he sign? Will this be a John Tavares-type situation where it goes to free agency?
We don't know
at this point. But listen, if you're a Devils fan – you got to be thrilled.
Yeah, you got to be thrilled.
Because you have a lot of reasons to be really excited about going to the Rock and watching this team play both now and in the future.
I think they turn the corner after last season. I think they make a big push. I think if Hall's healthy all year and Hughes is what we expect Hughes to be, even though he won't be what we know he can be in 3 or 4 years, as good as we think he can be as an 18-year-old, with Simmons as a guy who's a net front presence, Schneider hopefully back to playing at least, you know, quality goaltending with play. I think they're a playoff team.
All right.
I mean, it's a lot of ifs, but I don't think they're unreasonable ifs.
Yeah, it is a lot of ifs, but I don't necessarily disagree with you. I like a lot of the things that this team has, both moving forward this season and down the road. But, you know, we talk about bubble teams, bubble in, bubble out. I'm still worried about the goaltending with the Devils, and I'm a little concerned about the D. I know they added P.K. Subban, who I like. I think it's a big plus. Andy Green has been a really good player for a long time, getting a little long in the tooth. They may add Ty Smith, a rookie this year. I don't think they're rock solid on defense. And with my concerns about the goaltending, I'd have to say bubble out. But I do love what the Devils are doing, and it's been a great offseason.
Yeah, it has been a great offseason. I think they're a bubble team as well. I say bubble in, but negative Nelly over
here. Yeah, I know. Paint me as a negative guy.
Negative guy. Devils fans, you're going to the playoffs this
season. SeaWorld,
I
would say America, but it's more than that. SeaWorld, this is what happens.
Negative.
You know,
you're so
paint
negative.
I say a million positive things, and I get painted as negative.
Don't listen to them, Devils fans.
All right.
Don't
go Devils.